In this tutorial, I'll show you how to control particles to shoot out from a cannon like this. Let's try typing S and X to scale the cube on the X axis. It's scaling both ways, because the origin is located right in the middle. What if we move the cube like this, and move the origin to the 3D cursor? Let's type S and X again. Control 3 to subdivide. In edit mode, let's place two loop cuts by using the Control R shortcut. Mouse wheel up will add an extra loop cut. Let's scale them apart. In edit mode, let's select the right face and type I as in India to extrude inward twice. Type E to extrude inward once again. Type I once again to create a round face inward. There is our cannon mesh. We can rotate it like this thanks to the world center origin. What if we add particles to this mesh? If we go to edit mode, we'll still have the final round face selected. Let's create a new vertex group by typing Ctrl G. I typed 1 to select the vertices first, before pressing Ctrl G. We can tell the particle emitter to shoot out particles only from the selected vertex group. To make it shoot out, we need to either change the gravity or use the normal velocity. Let's see what would happen if we change the gravity. That looks cool, but what's going to happen if we rotate the cannon mesh? That's not what we want. Let's undo and use the normal velocity to see what that would do. What will happen if we rotate the mesh? That's exactly what we want. Let's create a low polygon UV sphere. We'll use that mesh as a particle object. I'll use an emission shader. Please use EV with bloom turned on. After this, I tried setting a keyframe on frame 1. Then I went to frame 250, rotated the mesh 359 degrees to set a new keyframe. But for some reason, that didn't work, so I had to remove the keyframes and try again. If this issue occurs to you, please right-click the keyframe region at the bottom to remove the keyframes and try again. I'm not sure why that didn't work on the first try, but it's working now. There's a bit of a lag at the tip of the cannon, and that's because the emitter is located way too deep inside the mesh. When this issue occurs, please move the emitter closer to the outer edge. I have used a subdivided cube to build a cannon for a learning purpose, but it's good to use a cylinder as a cannon mesh instead. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.